Hey Divi lovers, I have another quick tip for your Divi projects. I will show you how to implement super smooth, luxurious scrolling effect. Hi, my name is Anya and my goal here is to help you build beautiful websites. In this short video, I will walk you through implementing a Luxy.js script in Divi. Let's quickly look at their demo page. Usually when you stop scrolling on a website, this page stops right away. But here we have this inertia effect. It slows down gradually instead of stopping immediately, which makes the scroll feel much more smoother. Okay, so how do we use this in Divi? We have installation instructions right here. We have to include the script on our website and then initialize it. So let me show you. I am right here in my Divi theme options integration tab. Let's paste the code that I have here. So first, the first script, we are calling the Luxy min.js from CDN. You could also download it and call it locally if you like. And then I have that init function to initialize the script, and I wrapped it inside jQuery and also in a condition that checks if the body element has a ETFB CSS class. And that means that we will only run it if not in the visual builder. Okay, so with that right here, and before I save, let me show you a demo page. It's just one of pre-made layouts I just loaded on the page right here. And as you can see, I can go back and forth, stop at any given moment. And now if I save changes, so save that script right here and refresh my page. Now doing the same movements with my mouse, you see the page doesn't stop immediately. So that's that scroll effect in action. One thing that we have to be mindful, and you may want to use one or another version of the script. So here we are selecting the wrapper, and it will be page container only if you are not using fixed navigation. With default Divi navigation or in your theme builder header layout, you're using scroll effects with sticky position. If that's the case, if your navigation is fixed at the top, instead of page container, you would want to use et main area. I'm saving the changes, and now if I were to use fixed navigation, which I am, but right now you see the navigation is no longer fixed, but by changing that selector, let me refresh the page. Now the page still scrolls smoothly and my navigation remains fixed. So depending on whether you do have a fixed nav or not, you may want to change that wrapper attribute. Okay, but not sure if you saw it, some of the sections here in that layout use parallax effect on the section background, and it doesn't work super nice with that additional script that we've just implemented. So let me show you how we would fix that. Instead, like, we have to not use the built-in Divi settings for the parallax effect. So here, that section, background, I will actually remove the image altogether, because instead of the section settings, I would want to add additional row. Basically, the Luxy.js has the parallax built in, but it only applies to elements. We cannot use parallax on background image. So we will fake the background by using a row. So empty row, no modules inside. In my row settings, I will add the same background image that was here just for the section background. And now I want to extend the row to full height and full width. And actually even the height will need to be bigger to account for that parallax scroll. Like we will see parts of image as we scroll. So indexizing row settings with 100%, max with 100%, and then height, let's give it at least 150% height. We can also set min height. We won't see any change here, but it will work on the front end. And the final part we need is to position the row absolutely so that it sits on top of that section content. We want to set the Z index on that row and then make sure the other row in that section, the row with the actual content, has a higher Z index value. So here on that other row, Z index, I will leave it at 3. Now my row height is 150%, which means it bleeds outside of the section. So lastly, in the advanced tab of the section settings, I want to change the visibility and change the overflow to hidden. Okay, so that puts my row, my image, and displays it as a section background. One last thing we need is a custom CSS class. And it can be any class you can think of. It doesn't have to be anything specific, but we will need to use that class inside our JavaScript code. The way Luxy.js works is that you can control how quickly and with what type of offset the elements will move. Unfortunately, in Divi, we don't have a way to add data attributes to a row. We can only add ID and classes. So we will add these attributes with JavaScript in just a second. So let's call this element. It, like I said, it doesn't matter. It can be any class you like. Let's save the page. Exit the builder. So the element that needs to use that parallax effect has a class of element. Now it doesn't do anything just yet. We have to go back to our integration tab to scripts. And here we will add additional attribute to that init function. It's called targets. And here we can define CSS selector. So in our case, it's going to be element class. If I were to use multiple classes with various settings, I could add comma and then add element 2 and so on. Let's leave it like that. And now to add these data attributes that will control the position and the speed of the parallax effect, we need a little bit of jQuery. So instead of that CSS class, let's use element class. And then we are adding setting attribute data speed y, -5, and data offset 50. You can play with these values to see how the effect works. But for now, let me just save changes. Refresh the page here. Oh, okay, I know what went wrong. Let's enable the builder quickly. I shouldn't have set the position to center back here because the position will be calculated automatically on scroll. So back here, that setting, we don't want that. We want the default position. We don't want Divi interfering with how that element is positioned. Yes, we do want to use absolute, but no transformation and no margins should be applied. Save that. Exit the builder. And now you see the background scrolls with a slightly different speed. You see how it didn't fills the entire background. We can probably fix that by changing the offset maybe, I'm not sure which way, let's try with 80. Refresh the page. No, that made it worse, so maybe smaller offset, 20. I'm not sure. Now it's better. Okay, so we see the entire image as we scroll, and it scrolls with a different speed as parallax elements should. And technically, you can use this effect on various elements in the builder. You can apply additional CSS classes, play with different values for data attributes, but keep in mind that the behavior may not always be consistent. I would probably recommend using the parallax effect only on background elements where precise position is not that important. Maybe also in layouts with plenty of white space where you'd have enough room for the element to move smoothly. Okay, as always, I will include the code snippets on my Divi Lover blog. You also find a code version that excludes mobile devices, if that's what you need. I hope this is helpful. Do let me know in the comments. If you have any questions, feel free to get in touch. Thank you so much for watching and see you next time.